Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax. And I'm going to show you to get multiple 5 volts using breadboard from Arduino. In Arduino Uno, if you get this type of boards, this is a 5 volts pin. We have only one. And if you have this type of boards that you get from eBay or AliExpress, as you can see, this has 5 volts and it has one more 5 volts here. So we got 2 5 volts. But this pin header here that you see, ICSP, and also in this one, this is called in circuit system programming, and it has these pins. And this is used for SPI communication. SPI stands for Serial Peripheral Interface, where you can do programming or data communication between devices. This pin on the right side is VCC. The middle pin is for communication, and the last pin is ground. So we have 2 pins here. And in this case, this is VCC, that is 5 volts, exactly the same pin as this 5 volts, and the last one is the ground. So we have extra 5 volts, extra ground here. So this is 5 volts, and this is ground. But still, this is 5 volts, and you have second 5 volts, and if you need third or fourth 5 volts, then we can define these digital pins as extra 5 volts. And the amount of current that you get from 5 volts, it depends on your USB. If you power it from USB, then the amount of current is limited by the USB that you are connecting. For example, this port that you connect for your computer, from charger, from wherever you have, whatever is that, that will limit amount of current. If it is 1 ampere, you can get 1 ampere. If it's 2.4 ampere or 2.2 ampere, you will get that. But if you're powering it up, let's say from 7 to 12 or 13 volts, then the voltage comes here, goes to this regulator, which is AMS1117, this chip, and this has 1.1 ampere, 1100 milliampere, and here current limit for all these chip, for these voltages, 1.5, 2.8, and they have different voltage, but the one that is used is 5, and here the amount of current typical is 1100. So minimum is 900, typical is 1100. The maximum, it can go up to 1.5, but it needs heatsink and more and it needs cooling. But so keep in mind that that's the maximum that you can get from 5 volts, from this pin or from this pin. All of these two are exactly the same, connected to this chip, and also connected to the USB 5 volts. But if you get from this digital pins, which I'm going to show you how to use them as 5 volts, or if you use them as ground, in both cases, amount of current is 20 milliampere per pin. And here, Arduino official store, it says in out pin, 20 milliampere. So you cannot draw more than 20 milliampere. And if you get some current from 3.3 volts pin, that is 50 milliampere. Here is the situation that you want to control a servo, and at the same time you have a display. This display needs 5 volts and the servo needs 5 volts. Or maybe you have ultrasonic sensor and the servo. These both need 5 volts, or maybe the display. In any case, if you need extra 5 volts, I'm going to show you how you can have extra 5 volts in Arduino. Keep that in mind when you use Arduino's digital pin as a VCC or extra 5 volts. The maximum current that I can supply according to Arduino website is 20 milliampere. This is Arduino official website, and it shows that DC current per in out each can supply 20 milliampere. If you found this tutorial helpful, please thumb up and also click on the subscribe on the right side in the lower corner. I really appreciate it. Let me explain the code. First, we define a new constant. Let's name it VCC2. And
we will assign a pen to it. For example, right now we want to have pen 5 as a VCC. So just we put our 5, and remember there is no semicolon after define, and then we define another ground. You might not need this line because there is more than one ground, but in case if you need a ground, let's put the admin as well. And then we go inside the setup using the pen mode VCC2. This is as if I type 5 here, and we set pen 5 as an output. Then we use digital write and set the same pen high. When we set this high, this pen will have 5 volts. And then we do exactly the same thing, but this time we use this new variable. This means if I type 2, so we set pin 2 as an output and pin 2 low. Now this will act as a ground. Whatever other setting you have, you can add it here, and the rest of your code, if you need it, you can put it inside this loop. Here's the wiring from pin 5. This is my VCC. I've connected it to this point, and from here I have 1 kilo ohm resistor, which has been connected to this LED, to the anode, to the longer pin. And the anode is connected via this to pin 2, which is my ground. The code is being loaded. Once the code is loaded, you will see that this LED will turn on. And it is getting the power from pin 5. If I connect it to other pins, you will see that they do not have any power. Here I have connected this LCD 1602 to pin 5 and pin 2. And if you need higher current, use a breadboard, and I'm connecting it this red to the 5 volts, and on the breadboard this line is all connected as one piece from top to bottom, and this is another line, and they've labeled it with colors, so you can connect this 5 volts, for example, in here, and all this line will be now 5 volts will be available. You can connect to your devices. And the same way for the ground, I've connected it to the ground, and this will be connected to the second wire, and this will be all ground. And the same way you can do it on this side. For example, if you want to test this relay, this red is the VCC and this is the ground, and I'm connecting it. I will connect it to VCC in here. Any of those wire will be fine. And this one, any of this second wire line. So if I connect it, now this is powered up because all of this will have 5 volts. And also this powered up this way. That's it. This was how to get extra VCC and extra ground from Arduino Uno, Nano, and any Arduino. If you like this video and learn something, please thumb up. I have a lot of other videos related to Arduino. Please check them out by clicking in the link, which is the description, and you will see tons of other codes that I've written and tested. Don't forget to subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos. For more videos, please click on the subscribe button or click on the icon on the right side of the screen. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.